these guys are that good, that professional. They're the ones that have taken me up and down all these mountains and experienced what it's like to push yourself to another level. So I will give you guys details. It'll be on the screen of the numbers and that, because it's a great experience. Like, they're helping me, training me to get me to Mount Everest. But it's a great experience for all people concerned. They're a great bunch of blokes. Les, hey, I don't know if you can see him. He's they're very, very, very. He's the actual captain of the SES Victoria Country, and David behind. He is actually a Vietnam vet. So he was an officer in the Australian Army. So these guys, I'm actually very blessed to be with the actual top people.
In the water.
Am I socks aren't going to get wet?
Well, it doesn't matter, you finished the walk, yeah? But they should be waterproof.
Not on the wood, not on the wood. Okay, in the water, in the water. Okay,
well, now that was my water experience. So for everybody at Fitness First and Jayco, it's awesome out here with Australian Adventure Bound.
Adventure Guides Australia.
Adventure Guides Australia. These guys are just awesome. Okay, now here we go. We're walking up to... Thanks for that.
Are you filming?
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, everyone. I'm Jayco, I'm Fitness First. We've just done a 250 kilometre, a 4 kilometre climb,
four hour
hike up Mt Feathertop via Highland Peak via Mt Everest. I'm here with the two best climbers, mountaineers in Australia. Les and Dave. Dave's taking the filming, and it's very, very difficult. You know, it's a difficult thing. But thanks to Jayco for letting me train, and Jerry and Chris and Shannon and Fitness First and everyone in head office and Ian Dowson and GER. Like, it's hopefully, we'll raise millions of dollars for people with disabilities and their carers, and all you people, with disabilities like me who are listening to me and watching this and the carers. All you got to do is have a go, because I'm having a go, and honestly, I just made it, but I made it, so I'm having a go. So good luck and stay safe, and I'll see you in the next time.
woken up, it's about, what time is it, about 7.30 in the morning?
About 8 o'clock now.
It's about 8 o'clock in the morning. There's no en-suites. There's nothing out here. It's just you and the wilderness, which is great. And I was just saying to the guys, I said, why is there a scenario? And just over here is a Mount Buffalo through the trees, if you can see it. But we're up in high altitude. The night was freezing cold. Look, this is how I slept. You know, the whole thing. But the whole experience is, we were just talking about living in the city and not living in the city. This is where it's at. And I was saying to the guys, I said, do people think we're crazy? Is this crazy to do? Because it's so hard. It's not comfortable, but there's a sense of... there's a sense of enjoyment, believe it or not, when you're doing this. Like yesterday, I was dying. I was in excruciating pain. But I never once said, I've had enough, that's it. I'm not going to Island Peak. I'm not going to Mount Everest. I never ever said that. So I said to the guys, are we mentally there? And they said, yes, we are. But we love this is where humans actually grew up and started doing their stuff, not the cities. So I just want to say to people out here, this is what it's all about. It's hard. It's going to the toilet, not the right way, the prehistoric way, and having a wee, and there's no showers. I have one of the things that reminds me of here we go. I have an electric toothbrush in the wilderness. So there you go. But it's in the morning. We're doing another trek. Mount Buffalo's down there. These guys are fantastic for I'm learning the ropes. There's so much for me to learn. There's so much for me harder to train, to get used to carrying a 500 kilogram pack on my back and going up 10 kilometers and 50 kilometers. But it's an awesome feeling. Like, look at me. I'm wrecked. I'm broken, but I'm not broken. The more I go, the stronger I become. And this is what it's all about. Thank you very much for listening to me, because now we're going to pack up and get down there and you're just going to do it again and again. And David holding the camera says, Bobby, it's just a matter of keep doing it. Get in the wilderness as much as you can and do it, do it, do it. That's the only way you can train. And by the way, wouldn't be a bad idea if Jaco had a bush portable ensuite motorhome thing. I know it can't be done, but it's something to think about, Chris and Jerry. Thanks. Now I'm drinking the Tibetan Mount Everest cup of Mount Feathertop tea that David's made me to warm me up, and there's my toothy. Walking for 27 hours straight. Hello to the team at Jaco and Jerry and Chris and Shannon and everyone at in the gym, and Owen, thanks for the t-shirt. The person holding the camera is David from Adventure Guides Australia, which you're doing a magnificent job. It's like he's so caring for me. Yeah, it's a very tough gig, very tough challenge. After 27 hours, I haven't slept. I'm up in the mountains. The goal is Mount Everest, but it's a very, very exhausting and exhilarating thing at the same time. So whether you've got a disability or not, It's just pushing yourself and trying to achieve a goal. Whether you make it or not, that's not the point. Like, it's as long as you've had a go, and that's what the whole point is. You're still about 5 hours away from reaching the top, but in another, I don't know, 15 kilometres up, who knows, we'll get there. So I'll come back with you with a victory salute.
Feet sideways, Bobby. Nah, get your feet, get a foot in. You're letting you haven't got your feet sideways. Got to dig that upper part of your foot in.
It's to like kick a step in the side.
Yeah, just get your side grip, yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's okay. You'll get practiced at it. That's good. And then when you get to the track, off we go again. Minder, just keep coming. Yeah, we'll get back on the track. Use your poles.